Welcome back, friends. I hope you're blessed, and I hope that your hearts and minds are getting ready for Christmas. It's getting closer. Thanks so much for joining us for day 16 of the 24 days before Christmas. Day 16. On the 16th day of December, John listened to the weather forecast before breakfast, and snow was predicted again. The sky had the white look that means it's heavy with snow. John and I were so pleased, we ran almost the whole of the mile down the hill to wait for the school bus. A cold, raw wind was blowing, and we huddled into our parkas. After school, I had rehearsal. So did John, because he's singing in the choir, and this is the first time that the cast of the pageant and the choir have worked together. I tried hard to walk the way I did with the shoe to sub encyclopedia on my head, and to move my arms as though they were the graceful arms of a tree in spring, and not the bare, brittle branches of a tree in December. I remembered all my lines in my heart as well as my mind, and Mother had worked with me to make each word ring out clear and pure as a bell. Everybody seemed pleased, and John pounded me on the back and told me I was a whiz. The choir director congratulated me just as though I were a grown-up and told me that everybody was going to miss Mother in the choir, and I was forced once again to remember that Mother might not be home for Christmas. John asked the choir director if he thought it would snow, but he shook his head. It's turned too cold for snow. Mr. Irving, the choir director, drove us home and stopped in for a cup of tea. A big box of holly and mistletoe had arrived from our cousins on the West Coast. So John and Daddy hung the mistletoe on one of the beams in the living room. After Mr. Irving had left, we opened the day's Christmas cards the way we always do, taking turns so that each card can be looked at and admired and appreciated. John remarked, "Some people just rip open their cards in the post office. I bet the kids never see them at all. I'm glad we don't do it that way." "Everybody's different, John," Mother said. "That's what makes people interesting." "Well, nobody else I know does something every day during Advent the way we do. What's our special thing for today?" "Oh, I think the holly and the mistletoe's plenty. Start setting the table, Vic. It's nearly time to eat." Thanks so much again for joining us, folks. Have a blessed evening and a blessed Advent. Stay tuned for day 17 through 20. We'll see you next time.